Creating your own Yellena James picture, you need to sketch out the parts just really quickly, just using line and no tone. If you want to, you can use a wax crayon over some of these white lines so it doesn't show up when you use your watercolour paint. It creates that wax resist effect which we practiced last term. Now, when using your watercolours, you need to be really careful to mix them, not use the colours in the palette, you mix them so they are accurate. So for example, this bluey colour, at the moment that is too blue. I need to mix a green with that. Let's make it into more of a sea blue, and the same as the colour on the picture. Now, when I'm painting, I'm not just dabbing it on in strokes like this. That will make you slop over the edges. Instead, I use the point of my brush, keep my fingers right to the end so that I've got greater accuracy of the point of my brush against the edge of the line I'm painting. I paint long strokes downwards for greater accuracy. When that is all finished, you can start to add little bits of detail, like the little dots and the little lines that you wouldn't be able to do with a brush because they're just too tiny. You could use an ink pen. These are extremely sharp and need a lot of care when you're using them. You just need to dip them into the ink you want to use. Really careful and just dot them on like so. And there you have it, your own Yellena James picture. Instead of writing your critical analysis or the answers to the questions, you could, in a paragraph, you could write them around your picture as to make the words more decorative. So, for example, I used to know.